This episode of DNews is brought to you by Ting, mobile that makes sense. Science says our smartphones are a reflection of ourselves. So what does it mean if I've dropped mine in the toilet 3 times? Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and I've said it before, I will say it again, everything is disgusting, especially your cell phone. It's like a tiny bacteria delivery device. And a new study shows that those bacteria are indeed a reflection of you. A group of researchers from the University of Oregon sequenced microbes from the index fingers and thumbs of 17 subjects, as well as microbes from the surface of their smartphone touchscreens. The goal was to see if our favorite and most widely used possessions resemble us, microbially speaking. And it turns out, they do. Researchers found that 82% of the most common bacteria found on the subject's fingers were also present on their phones, meaning your personal microbiome, which is the specific collection of bacteria that's unique to every person, closely resembles the bacteria on your phone. The three most commonly found ones were Streptococcus, Staphylococcus, and Corynebacterium, which is a mostly harmless bacteria that lives on human skin, but has been known to cause diphtheria, an upper respiratory tract illness. Interestingly, they also found that women seem to share more microbial similarity with their phones than men do, although there's no current explanation on why that may be. Now, it's kind of obvious that our cell phones would match us, since most of us are glued to them all day long, but the study does have some interesting implications. Specifically, it paves the way for potentially using someone's personal effects as a means of monitoring their health. Not only is it non-invasive, it doesn't really require direct participation from the person, meaning it could be a fast and easy way to conduct large-scale microbial studies, analyze our exposure to biological threats, or screen the microbes of hospital and healthcare workers. Currently, one in every 20 patients at a healthcare facility will contract a hospital-acquired infection at some point, so being able to screen those people and their caretakers could prevent the spread of disease as well as thousands of hospital-related deaths. Sounds like a pretty good deal. And speaking of good deals, if you do have a cell phone, which of course you do, because it's 2014, then you gotta check out Ting. Ting is a new mobile phone service that puts the power back in your hands and saves you a ton of money in the process. With Ting, there are no yearly contracts, no plans, and no hidden fees, and you only pay for the data and minutes you actually use. A novel concept, but a good one. All of your monthly bills come with complete transparency, so you can see exactly what you're getting charged for. They also have great 24/7 customer service, so if you have any questions at all, you can always call, and you are guaranteed to get a real live human on the other line. Did I mention that it's cheap? If you hit up dnews.ting.com and click on their savings calculator, you can see just how much Ting would save you over the next 2 years. 98% of customers save money just by switching, so what do you have to lose? Hit up dnews.ting.com, and remember, every visit to that link helps support the show. In the meantime, if you have questions, comments, anything you want to say about this episode, just leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.